Hello, Venu this side. In this video, I am explaining how to install IntelliJ. I am explaining in this YouTube description. I already shared one link that is nothing but ideas in this URL. Just please always click on this community edition only. This is free, no need to pay 1 rupee also. So I recommend always please click this black color. I already downloading completed, that is in my screen, okay, in my desktop. Okay, now first time if you want to install, that's one more important thing. These in IntelliJ, if I want to explain exactly what is this IntelliJ. IntelliJ is nothing but one IDE. Means maybe you are using Oracle at the time, you are using SQL developer, you are using Java at the time, you are using Eclipse and Maven. Same way, this is also this is nothing but IntelliJ. IntelliJ integration for it is a big data or a scalar related projects at the time. Most of the members using IntelliJ. I recommend to use this one. Eclipse also is fine, but I don't recommend. Now you will get Eclipse something pop up box. If you are interested, if you are installing, you will get pop up. Yes, click yes. Now where you want to where you are installing this IntelliJ, I recommend. I think earlier I said create C drive. In that C drive, go to big data. In that big data, click OK. At the time, what happened? IntelliJ, you are installing in that C drive. That is that meaning. Okay, all these are optional. Okay, if you want to click or if not interested, ignore that. Okay, now click install. Just it will take few seconds. Okay. The main reason, if you install in that big data folder, what happened? All important big data softwares available in this folder only. One more important thing, after installation, everything completed, no need this. If you want, delete this, all these unnecessary softwares. Okay, Hadoop, zip files, everything delete. That's not a problem. Okay. Maybe after 5 minutes, maybe this is almost installation completed, this IntelliJ. Finally, you will get this one. I recommend please check this check button. And finish. Okay, now SBD also fine. Okay, I already installed just now. Double click and everything. Next. No need to change one line also. SBD and double click and the next. Everything same. I already installed. That's why no need. Okay, now after that IntelliJ you will get like this. Okay. Check this one. Continue. Continue. Okay. Next. Maybe it will take a while. Wait. First time, if you execute anything, it will take a little time. Wait. Okay, now first time if you are doing, go to plugin. Now go to install. Don't forget that this is first time only, one time activity. No need to this activity daily, just only one time. And restart again. Okay, you will get a restart IntelliJ like that. You will get one. Now restart IDE and restart. Maybe it will take time. Just wait. Then maybe you will get like this. Please click now project. Just wait. New project, projects, and click on projects. Okay, just wait. Maybe my system little slow, and click on the scala, SBT, and next. If you forgot, if you not install scala plugin, this is not available at the time. So don't forget that. Next, I recommend use Spark POC like that something name. Maybe by default install IntelliJ in this folder, but this is also my recommendation. Give something name called big data. At the time, all big data software installed in this folder only. If I think about automatically, it will identify where is Java located. If it is unable to identify, okay, please configure this one. Maybe add JDK and go to C drive. Okay, C drive and big data folder and Java and JDK. Here you have JDK, you know, just configure like this. Okay, one more thing, my recommendation here is Spark. 5 minutes back you notice what is Spark version. Spark by default using 2.12.10th version, this one. If you want left hand side, back side, please check. Okay, that's why I always use that version. SBT anything is fine, don't worry. Okay, now create. You will get pop up like this. Don't worry, please click create. Okay, then you will get like this. Then you will get like this. Usually it will take little time. Okay, within this time, okay, you will get something pop up. Click close. Why? This is nothing but tips. My recommendation, this black color is not eye friendly. If you are interested, black color, okay, that's not a problem. Otherwise, if you want to change this white color, then what happened? Go to file, go to setting. Okay, here appearance. In that appearance, there is a Dracula, you know, instead of Dracula, use IntelliJ light. At the time, you will get white color. Okay, next, my recommendation, go to SRC. SRC means, here it is, if you wait some time, you will get sky blue color. If you get sky blue color, then only you can do it anything. Don't forget that. Maybe that's also, it will take little time. Please wait. Okay, now what happened? Maybe I want to practice Spark. I want to practice Spark. Then what happened? My recommendation. Okay, this is only recommendable, not mandatory. Okay, go to file, project structure. Go to project structure. Okay, here go to modules. This is very, very important and 100% everyone must aware of it. What is that? Go to dependencies. Why here automatically you will get scale 212, but still why is not available? Just wait, here it's still synchronizing. Synchronizing means downloading dependencies from internet. It will take little time. Similarly, if you are using Eclipse, in that Eclipse you are using form.xml, you know, form.xml, everything you can configure here. This is called build.sbt. Okay, like Spark, etc., anything, that's not a problem. Okay, use like this. That is also fine. Okay, usually it will take little time. Please wait. Similarly, this is only my recommendation. My recommendation. If you want to practice Spark, especially Spark, at that time, go to file. Maybe synchronizing processing completed, just is taking too few seconds. Then go to file. This is my recommendation only, not mandatory. Why? I'll guide you. Here, go to scalar. New scalar. Here, package. My recommendation, first package. com.bigdata.spark.sparksql. Like that. Create one package. Okay, right click, new. Scalar class, testing, like that, create object. If you create object, what happened? By default, you will get like this. At the time, create a main method. This is written little headache topic. Any Spark object you are creating, all these things, import something. That is little headache topic. That's why my recommendation, go to file. Okay, project structure. Okay, here now please check file. After synchronizing everything completed, you got it like this. After that, my recommendation, go to plus jar and directory. What is that meaning? You are adding dependencies manually. All Spark dependencies available in this folder, big data, Spark, jars. please add this jar. If you add this jar, 99.9% all important jars available in this folder. That's it. 99.9%. Okay. Click OK. Similarly, one more important step. Go to setting. Earlier project structure. Now go to setting. In that setting, please search. Okay. TEMP template. Search template. Here, please scroll down middle. Somewhere you have scalar class, scalar object. Delete this one. Just paste this one. Just now in this YouTube description, I shared this code. Hash if something something. You know, please copy all these things and paste here. Why? If you created any other object, let example, create one more object. Okay, right click and create one more object. Earlier you got it like this. But if you create it is new object, create object. Now what happened? Automatically you will get all these things. It is recommendable, not mandatory. Okay, here from 14th line you can do it all Spark related activities. Now if you want, please note, don't forget to add these dependencies. Okay, add dependencies means file, project structure here. Okay, go to dependency modules above this one and go to dependencies and plus add these jars. If you add these jars, 99.9% all dependencies available. Maybe you want to practice data sets. In this YouTube description, I already shared this data set link also. Maybe I want to process USA data. Okay, now take this data set. Val data is a quote. Really Spark working or not? Testing purpose. Okay. Val df is equal to Spark read format CSV. Okay, compiling, there is no any error. Now it's processing. Usually first time it will take little time. Please be patient. Okay, then now if it is showing adjustments, yes, congrats. From now you can do it anything. Okay. For example, I want to process this within this time. By time based, I will prepare script. But it is maybe I want to run SQL queries. Just now I prepared. Okay, now this is the data, USA data. What happened? Maybe in this data I want to only something California records. At the time, what happened? This is data frame. I am creating one name is called tab. Okay, now run SQL query. Select star from tab where California state is called California. This one. Okay. That's it. So Spark 100% is working.